Thank you all so much for joining us from far and wide across the province. We're in a room full of people who are not necessarily focused on the things that grab headlines every day, or the controversies, or the meanness that we're surrounded by. The people that are joining us tonight in this room are people who look after children and families, which is the most noble and important pursuit that any of us can take on. So please give yourselves a round of applause. My name is Kathryn Gretsinger. I'm delighted to be here to MC once again. I was trying to figure out how many years it's been, and I think I should not count. I love to be here, and it's a wonderful event, and it's so nice to celebrate all of you. We have a remarkable young man who is going to be our keynote speaker this evening, and he's a real personality. He's got a whole speech ready, and you're not going to hear it, because he's working the room, and he's collecting stories, and he's going to be up here to blow your minds in less than an hour. And he really wants you to use the hashtag FCGala19. He's quite disturbed that we're not using this hashtag to great effect. So let's get on that for Michael. Hashtag is FCGala19. So go on Twitter, go on Facebook, send out an Instagram shot, and let's get that social media going to get other people who can't be with us tonight into this room with us. Before we go any further, I just want to acknowledge that we are standing on the traditional territories of the Musqueam, the Squamish, and the Tsleil-Waututh people. And we are very fortunate this evening to have Debra Sparrow with us to provide a traditional greeting. Debra, as many of you will know, is a very well-known artist from the Musqueam community. She's somebody who brings people together. And in fact, she's just telling me at the table that tomorrow, 80 of her beautiful blankets are going to be distributed through the treehouse over on Broadway to kids being taken into care. So it's just such a lovely way to share culture and love. So it is really my pleasure to welcome a very important member of our community, Debra Sparrow.
Good evening, everyone. Nice to be back again. I'm starting to feel like I'm been here a few years to becoming part of the fixture here. I don't mind those, some pretty fixtures here. But, you know, as mentioned, you're on our traditional territory, the Musqueam, actually, because we have a protocol agreement with our other two tribes that we're in different areas throughout the city. This is actually Musqueam territory, and when we sort of sway over to Vancouver City, it becomes a shared territory. So we have a lot of shared territories, but we also have our different areas where we know our villages were, and we're right by the Fraser River, as you know, and that's kind of our highway to meet all of the people in the villages that we had pre-contact. During that time, something that was instinct to us is how we looked after our children and raised them up to be fine young people and fine adults. I have four grandchildren now, and I've been a very big part in being with them and raising them and sharing with them and traveling. And it reminded me a little bit when she said FC, I was going to say, be careful, we might think it's a football club. We have all of our Vancouver FC and all the soccer, and that's what our kids do. Today we have such an amazing group of young people coming up under a certain age. And for the time that, you know, we struggled as people with our identity, with who we were for those 100 years of what happened to our people, we are now embracing and pulling, I like to use my mom's words when she'd say, we have to pull up our own socks. And that's what we're doing. We can't anymore project out what has happened. We're going to turn around and we're going to go inward, and we're going to call upon our ancestors and our own ancestral knowledge to put back in place how we value our kids, how we raise them up. And you know, I travel to a lot of schools, and when I talk to a lot of the young people in schools, and I share with them what we're doing to give the connection back to our children through our culture, there's a part of a ceremony when you become a young person. And some cultures still do that today. But I ask schools when I go in, because I want to know what young people are thinking, not just watching the internet. If you had a ceremony available to you as a young person to come of age, would you do it? And you know, 90% of them put up their hand and say yes. Because we're not giving them that. We're putting them through school and we love them and we're giving them some guidance, but there's a part of the ceremony that shares with you in growing yourself as a woman or a man. And we need that back. We need to replace the internet in the way in which our kids are looking, or maybe introduce it through there. Gotta have balance. Maybe that would be a good idea, but I hold my hands up to each and every one of you for all the work that you do, and to welcome you to travel from wherever you came to be here together tonight, because gathering like this is so important. It reminds me of our longhouses when in the winter we gathered together and we discussed and we shared and we gathered like you are tonight, so we can have conversations, we can have sharing together what it is important for us and our children. But you know, it's not just us with the knowledge. Those kids come into the world with knowledge. They share it with us, but we sometimes take it away from them. And sometimes we don't listen to them because we think they're too young to know something. So when I get into arguments with my grandchildren, I take a deep breath and step back and I allow them to finish what they're saying and doing, and we have a talk about it. And I find it works so well that way, because there was a time when I raised my three, I was probably screaming at them more. But I was screaming at them because as we moved out of some of the things that happened, our parents were yelling at us, because that's what everybody did in those days. So we just passed that on, but we're learning to take a step back and allow these youth to grow and to have a voice. And I think that's important, is that they have a voice, all of the youth in this room. So again, I hold my hands up to you, and on behalf of my chief, Wayne Sparrow, who, yes, I've said last year and year before, is my younger brother, and he's chief, and I taught him everything he knows, that's why he's chief. I'm actually wearing his replica of his blanket that my sister and I made for him when he became chief. And you know, we're not only political people, but you know, my grandfather, who was one of the forefront chiefs, winning a Supreme Court case, but he had a sense of humor, and he always said to me, don't always be so serious, you know. And he liked to joke and have a sense of humor. So when my brother got in to be chief, he walked into a community center where I was, and there wasn't a lot of people around, but I said to him, Wayne, and he's like, yeah, I'm going to buy one of your blankets. And I said, no, I don't want to say that to you. I said, Wayne, you know, I'm really proud of you. I said, and if Dad was here, which I'm sure he is in spirit, and Grandpa, they would be proud of you. But I'm going to tell you something, brother. I said, I don't want you to follow in their footsteps. And I don't want you to try to fill their shoes. I want you to make your own way in this world that we live in now, with a new way of thinking, but to keep both of them by your side. And ask for guidance sometimes when you need it, and you won't always, because we live in a different world than they did. So don't try to follow in Dad's footsteps, and don't try to fill Grandpa's shoes. Make your way. And he said, wow, I thought you were going to ask me to buy one of your blankets. I said, well, I'm going to do that too. So what we do is we brought back, after 150 years of our blankets disappearing from us, we brought them back some years ago now, and they're so valuable in understanding what these women were doing and how they taught their children. How together they built their families and their lives around what was valuable and to them. And so blankets are so significant to all of us. I'm teaching women who are not First Nations, but I'm teaching them because they too are weavers. Everybody in the room is a weaver. We all come from a culture and a history, and it's the fibers of who we are, and it's the fibers of life. So it doesn't matter if we come from Norway or Japan or Africa or the other side of the world, we're weavers. So I teach them technique, and then they go home and study their design elements and bring them, and then we put them together on the main work that they're working on. And they're connected. And they have said to me, Debra, you don't know what you gave back to me. And I said, yes, I do, because I've been doing this for 30 years, and I know that it was something that was missing in my life. And now if I can step out and share that with you, then we're going to weave our way through this world in a more positive, balanced way. And so last year when I got asked to work with the mural painters of the city of Vancouver, you might have seen the pillars under Granville Island, it was time to take the elements from the blankets out and let everybody see them in a different way, in a more modern way. So we painted the murals down on the pillars under Granville Island and the one over at the Biltmore on 12th Avenue. And so they're for all of us. They're for the city of Vancouver to be proud of who they are in the relationship with the people here and the people of the land. And we build relationships that way. And we teach our children that we can all get along together and that we have a place for each other here in what we call Vancouver. And so I'd like to hold my hands up to an announcement I heard in the TV before I came today. John Horgan announced more money for everybody, and it was positive. So I want to hold my hands up to him for making that decision for our children and for the caretakers who look after them and the people that care about them. So I hope you enjoy your evening tonight, and I hold my hands up to each and every one of you, as I said earlier, because that is our way of showing respect to you. So, hi, CMT, to each and every one of you, and I hope you enjoy your evening. Thank you.